Most people in America are familiar with how we provide a prayer card to a church, how we write something on a prayer wall, or how we do something to give people the prayers that they need most of all. The prayer that a person needs most of all is not up to you. The prayer that a person needs most of all is usually up to the person who is leading the prayer. The problem is that you can be praying against people's lives that aren't your lives to be praying against. You see, the Lord God above makes everyone and every situation, but He doesn't make every condition. What He does do is allow people free will, and sometimes those people exercise their free will in a way that harms other people. They lie to themselves about what their rights are underneath the federal laws that protect our rights. They think, well, I'm his big brother, I'm their big sister, I can do whatever I like and no one will know. And if we all do this, if we all gang up, then everybody will be okay and he'll have to go. Well, here's the problem. While you're doing all this, his elderly parents are dying. And while you're doing all this, you're taking away his rights. And while you're doing all this, you are interfering by putting some female person in place who can be pretending to be someone while you're not there. And openly, that person's an alcoholic, but you don't want to believe that. And openly, when it's been brought to your attention, you still don't want to believe that. And when it is brought to your attention, you often say you don't care because there's no way an alcoholic would ever drink on the job or ever drink when they're transporting someone somewhere. You see, what you did was establish a relationship with someone outside the covenant of marriage. What you also did was establish a relationship with someone who does not have any wherewithal and doesn't have a care, is not true, has a lot of worries, and a lot of woes, and is literally a person of interest in a way that she might have done this to destroy the family. Or did you do this? Did you, in your infinite wisdom, decide that you were going to steal all your brother's property? And did you, in your infinite wisdom, decide you were going to create a sexual harassment situation on his life that he had nothing to do with? And did you, in your infinite wisdom of Satan, decide you were going to be so fucking selfish at the end of your father's and mother's life that you're going to deny him the right to see them? So let's talk about you. Who did you marry? Because who you married proved who you are today. Who you married and how your children behave prove who you are today. That can be a tall order to face if you're standing in front of Jesus Christ. So why don't you stand there for a little while? Why don't you stand in front of God and explain to the Lord what you've been doing to someone's body? And if you're not a Christian, if you're not a Christ worshiper, if you're not at all a God worshiper, I'm going to ask you, what the fuck are you doing in America, after all? Because you see, America was founded based on religion and a freedom of faith and a freedom to pursue religion in any way. But it does not provide you, Miss Muslim, you, Mr. Muslim, you, this lying people about who you are from Muslim countries, the right to commandeer a body and try to fix it in your way. Under no circumstances do you have the right to anyone's sexual organs. Under no circumstances do you have the right to human traffic someone, you little fucking panhandler. And under no circumstances do you have the right to provide private information because you're illegally and immorally listening to someone who never gave you their fucking channel, which means you opened a bag, which means you did something illegal, you did something immoral, and every fucking time you walk by that man, he's ready to kill you and your husband, because he has said, stop, in the name of the law, leave me alone. But you don't listen. So when that man says stop, you say, I don't care, I don't have to stop, I'm not a part of the world, I'm not a part of the law. Bullshit. Your lie just puts you in a situation to fry for your lie, because you are nothing to that man, not one bit. And if you've infiltrated his conversation networks, if you steered off someone who came to get him, he will literally find a gun under American law, come after your fucking life in 3-6 months from now, and you will never know what hit you. So do not play in someone's relationships. Never play in their family, and never interfere in someone else's life, my dear, because if someone didn't teach you the rules of life are live and let live. But the rules of life say you don't have the right to use your profession to steal information. But the problem really is you're so significantly on alcohol, you're so significantly on drugs, you're not even listening to your own husband who's saying stop. that man is showing me regard, and he's not your friend. And the minute you try to insult him like that, you might be beaten down to the end. But we do have panhandlers that, according to their own kind, their own family even, say that they're lying about everything all the time. And it's amazing what happens if you just listen. But here's what I can tell you. Those elderly people in that black community there, in that satanic community there, in that Indian community there, are getting young people to lie, steal, and cheat Americans out of their life here.